Hey, YouTubers and RV fans. So this is my first big trip in the new Fleetwood Surge. And I'm headed out for Louisiana. And it's interesting because the RV had some really big steering issues when I first bought it. And the dealership was supposed to address that. You know, after doing a lot of research online, about it, I realized that the E450 chassis really has some pretty poor reviews in terms of its steering and control and the need for, you know, typically for alignment after the RV's been placed on the chassis. And many times the manufacturer doesn't do an alignment. So I know for a fact that this particular RV was driven down from Elkhart, Indiana to Florida where I bought it. It's interesting that the person who drove it didn't necessarily, put in the comments or anything about this RV that, you know, the steering was, it wasn't just bad, it was dangerous. I drove from Plant City, Florida to to Arcadia, Florida, and I could barely keep it on the road. And I really thought to myself, my God, there's no way I would be able to keep it on the road, especially when there is construction and you have to really stay right in your lane. So I called the dealership and, you know, I said, you guys were supposed to have addressed this issue. And of course they didn't. And they really never gave me a response, but that was on the pre-delivery inspection. So that right there in itself is a, an idea for you. Make sure you have the things that you don't like on your PDI listed. So anyway, to make a long story short, I realized very quickly that you cannot take an RV into any Ford dealer. It has to be a truck dealer in particular, and they're the only ones that will actually do it, because they're the only ones that typically have the equipment to lift an RV as heavy as this Class C is. So I didn't want to have to extend my stay longer in Florida, because I really need to get to Louisiana and start my other, you know, trips out to Colorado, and of course, you know, meeting up with Dawn and Mike. So I called all around the area where I bought the RV, and not one Ford dealer had any ability to do the alignment for me or check the front end suspension or any of those things. The one dealership that I did call was Gator Ford in, somewhere in the middle of Florida. And they were very nice. And he said he would put me on the schedule, but it would be 30 days before I could get in. And of course, we're in the height of season here. So as a result, you know, there's a million RVers. So I'm sure that that's the reason why. And, you know, that's fine, but I wasn't gonna wait 30 days. But I was reading some of the reviews on the E450, and I read one review about Mr. Front End, which is in Punta Gorda. And I thought, you know, what the heck, I'll give it a call. He had almost a 5-star rating. And, you know, so I called and I said, listen, I need, you know, XYZ done. Can you do it? And he was like, yeah, bring it in. And, he said, it's going to take me the whole day, but, you know, bring it in. So I brought it in today. And I have to tell you, I picked it up at about 2:30 this afternoon, the RV, and have been driving since then. We've gone about 150 miles, and it's like night and day. The thing steers beautiful, and there's really, it's really a very nice and comfortable change. It tracks straight, it doesn't track over to the right or to the left, and it's been a really enjoyable ride. And so, in any event, I wanted to share that story with you, give you a little bit of an update. I'll be getting back to more of a routine schedule for videos. I've got a couple things in the RV I have to tell you about. Oh, so much to catch you up with, because it's been a couple days since I've put a video out. The last video I put out, I think, was the tour video. And so, let's see. We were in Toby's RV Resort in Arcadia, Florida. It is at Encore Park. And what a great place that was. And Angel, who was one of the, I don't know if she was the manager or not, but Angel was just really sweet and took good care of us. We got there on a Saturday late afternoon, and the office was closed. And I had a little bit of a panic attack, because there was nothing left for me in the box for late check-in. So I called Thousand Trails and talked to the reservation specialist there, and they were very nice, and they had a back line and got a hold of Angel, and Angel gave me my site number, and I went back to my site. It was beautiful. It was at the end, or at, way in the back of the park, which I love, and it was up against the field, and the sunsets and the sunrises were really quite beautiful. So had a very nice time at Toby's RV park, RV resort. And thanks, Angel, if you're watching. It was a great stay. So we left there early. We left there early yesterday, and we boondocked in Mr. Front End's parking lot, which was fine. It was a great experience. It was very quiet. I ran the generator for a few hours, but the nice thing about this RV is that the batteries are brand new, and so they lasted all night long, which was really great. In fact, they still have four bars today. All the systems are working on the RV, and they're working magnificently. So, very happy about all that. Okay guys, wanted to let you know that I have arrived at my location. I'm all set up. It's a nice little park here. Busy. It's a very busy park. Lots and lots of people here. So thanks for tuning in. Please thumbs up the video if you like it. Subscribe, and I'll look forward to seeing you on the next video.